Hello everyone, myself Neha Gupta. I hope you all are familiar with me. I am your mentor of current affairs. So what is the topic of today? The topic today that I am going to discuss with you all is how can you prepare your own fact sheet. Yes, the picture that you are seeing behind me, what am I supposed to read from it and what do I learn from this? These must be the questions that hover in your mind whenever you read Spotlight magazine or any other magazine, be it your PIB 247, be it even your static portion PDFs, right? So here what I have done is I have prepared a fact cheat sheet for you all. So let's move into that and learn what are the ways in which we can create our own fact sheet. So guys, here you can see that I have created a fact sheet for you all. First, let me show you the overall performa of the fact sheet that I have prepared. But guys, do keep this thing in your mind that this is not a standard which you all have to follow. You can make the fact sheet on the basis of your likings, on the basis how you remember the facts well. Okay, I did it in terms of the sections. Like I have clubbed together all the IIT's news from the month of March together in this one section, and remember the section and all the news that I have taken in this fact sheet are from the month of March only. So March spotlight I picked up, and remember this is not the complete spotlight, okay? Because if we discuss here the complete spotlight, then it is going to take a lot of time here, and my purpose is not to consume a lot of your time. My purpose here is to strategically tell you how can you prepare your own fact sheet. And do remember, if I provide you this fact sheet, the PDF of this, and you take a printout of it, then it would be a little bit harder for you to memorize it, because once we write, we create a lot of images, we create visualization in our own mind. Therefore, it is an old saying that reading always help you, but writing does excellent work. Okay, so if you want to remember the visualization, if you want to remember the facts for a longer period of time, so my recommendation for all of you would be to learn how can you prepare your own fact sheet and then make it on a sheet of paper on your own, okay? And there are some people who can make the fact sheet on computer and then take out a printout, and then they are able to memorize the facts. So whichever way suits you the best, choose that way. But here my task is to tell you how can you move ahead, okay? But again, the ultimate decision would lie in your hands. So on that note, let's begin with the fact sheet. Let's discuss how can you prepare the fact sheet. But before that, let me show you the complete performa. So I have divided the spotlight of March into sections. All the IIT news that I found in the month of March are clubbed here. All the government schemes. Remember, these are not the complete government schemes that are covered in spotlight. Just 10 government schemes I have taken up here for discussion. Then here are the news from the national section. Then here is the news from the banking section. And banking ko bhi maine sections mein divide kiya hai. RBI ka alag, SEBI alag, and individual companies alag. For example, all the news related to RBI, the reasons for which RBI was there in the news, all of these reasons are put here. Now this will help me in memorizing what are the reasons, why was RBI in the news, and what are the specific news that are important from the RBI section, right? So you can write banking and economy as well, and you can just write down all the news, whichever way suits you the best. Categorization is one way which suits me the best when it comes to memorizing. Therefore, I have categorized the news. Okay, so here you have the government schemes and you have the RBI section, and this is against the government scheme. Guys, understand that I have taken just one paper. It is created in a manner so that you take out one sheet of paper, divide the sheet of paper into halves, and then on the one hand side you can write down the news. Once you are done with that section, you can move on to the other half of the page. Okay, so in this manner you can see that here the news is written, but this side is a bit empty because government schemes, guys, again is a lot to cover. Okay, and here last but not the least, I'm going to talk about the important days. How can you memorize the important days better? Okay, so let's discuss about the news. How can we write down the main points from the news itself? Okay. So I hope by now all of you must have covered the spotlight of the month of March. So you would easily be able to recognize the news. So here, guys, two tips are from my side. First tip is, at least do revision of spotlight. At least read spotlight 2 times, okay, before making your short notes. Or at least 1 time तो आपको read करना ही पड़ेगा spotlight को. उसके बाद ही आपको समझ में आएगा कि कौन सी IIT या कौन सा news हमने पहले cover कर लिया और उसकी क्या recent developments बाद में है, या फिर कितना किस news को हमें importance देना. वो भी आपको एक बार reading तो ज़रूरी है, उसी के बाद समझ में आएगा. ठीक है, तो फर्स्ट टाइम रीडिंग आप ज़रूर कीजिए, उसके बाद अपने शॉर्ट नोट्स बनाइएगा. जब आप सेकंड टाइम या थर्ड टाइम रिवीजन कर रहे होंगे स्पॉटलाइट की, तब आप अपने नोट्स बनाइएगा. सेकंड टिप फ्रॉम माय साइड इज, डू नॉट राइट एवरीथिंग दैट कम्स योर वे ऑन द शीट ऑफ पेपर, बिकॉज अदरवाइज द पर्पस ऑफ इट वुड बी डिफीटेड. द पर्पस हियर इज टू स्किम द क्रीम आउट ऑफ द मिल्क. ओके, सो दैट इज़ द पर्पस. सो उसके लिए हमें सिर्फ और सिर्फ मेन पॉइंट्स ही लिखने हैं यहाँ पर, क्योंकि अदरवाइज ज़्यादा फैक्ट होंगे तो आपका माइंड भी आपको धोखा देगा, फिर वो याद करने में आपकी हेल्प नहीं करेगा. ठीक है, सो हैव अ लुक एट द IIT. सो देर आर 3 reasons फॉर विच IIT मद्रास रिमेन्ड इन द न्यूज़ इन द मंथ ऑफ मार्च. एंड वॉट आर दोज 3 reasons? फर्स्ट रीज़न इज दैट वे इन कोलेबोरेशन विद नेशनल इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ ओशन टेक्नोलॉजी, ओशन 22 कॉन्फ्रेंस वॉज ऑर्गेनाइज. सो वट आर दी वर्ड्स दैट आई हैव रिटन हियर? ओनली द की वर्ड्स, IIT मद्रास, द कोलेबोरेशन विद द इंस्टीट्यूशन विच इज डिनोटेड बाय दिस प्लस. यू कैन चूज वट एवर साइन सूट्स यू द बेस्ट. प्लस इज सिम्बॉलिकली द प्लस मीन्स एडिशन और कोलेबोरेशन. दैट इज वाई आई रोट प्लस हियर इक्वल्स टू ओशन 2022 कॉन्फ्रेंस. सो दिस साउंड्स लाइक अ मैथमेटिकल इक्वेशन, बट if it is helping us, then what is the harm of taking recourse to maths? Then again, one additional fact that might skip your mind is that 2021 to 30 is the UN decade for ocean science for sustainable development. Now this is again an extra fact given along with this news, but still, since it is a static fact, you can write it here in short words, okay, like I have done here. Then the second reason for which IIT Madras remained in the news is that it had created or set up a new brain research center, and it is clearly evident from the sentence itself, new brain research center. Now why did I suggest you to have a reading once or twice of spotlight before making your short notes? Because it would help you in choosing the words that you have to write down here, because otherwise if you haven't done the reading of spotlight and you are only picking up the bold words that are there, you won't be able to make sense out of it when you read the complete fact sheet. Okay, so in order to make sense out of this fact sheet, अगर मैं आपको सिर्फ इतना पोर्शन दे दूँ और आपको कुछ भी ना बताऊँ, स्पॉटलाइट आपने पढ़ी ही नहीं है, तो क्या आप इसका सेंस बना पाओगे कि क्या कहना चाह रही हूँ मैं यहाँ? नहीं ना. तो इसीलिए कह रही हूँ कि पहले स्पॉटलाइट पढ़ना और फिर शॉर्ट नोट्स बनाना, क्योंकि तो उसके बाद आपको समझ में आएगा कि ठीक है, दिस इज़ द फैक्ट एंड दिस मच इज़ द इन्फॉर्मेशन दैट आई कैन कॉन्सेप्चुअली रिमाइंड माई माइंड ऑफ, ओके, व्हेन आई एम डूइंग द रिवीजन. नाउ द थर्ड पॉइंट हियर इज, or the third reason or the third news regarding the IIT Madras, which is of very much importance, is that it collaborated with RBI Innovation Hub. And what is the purpose? Cooperate FinTech, matlab cooperation in the FinTech segment. So this is the third news, okay? So in these 3 words, your entire news is summarized. Then IIT Roorkee was there in news because of the Roorkee वाटर कॉन्क्लेव. ओके, सो रुड़की वाटर कॉन्क्लेव से ही आपको समझ में आ जाएगा दैट इट इज़ दी IIT रुड़की विच हैज़ ऑर्गेनाइज इट. बट ऑब्वियसली एग्जामिनर इज़ वेरी श्रूड, द एग्जामिनर इज़ नॉट गोइंग टू मेक क्वेश्चन आउट ऑफ दिस रुड़की वाटर कॉन्क्लेव. रादर वॉट कुड बी द क्वेश्चन? द थीम. सो वॉट इज़ द थीम? वाटर सिक्योरिटी फॉर सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट. हाउ एवर आई चोज दी फुल वर्ड्स, यू कैन ऑल्सो राइट शॉर्ट फॉर्म्स, ओके, बिकॉज जितने कम शब्द होंगे उतना ही ज़्यादा आपको ईजी होगा याद करने में. बट डू रिमेंबर दिस थिंग कि इतने भी शॉर्ट मत बनाना नोट्स कि जब आप खुद उसे फेस टू के टाइम पर रिवाइज करने बैठो तो आप खुद ही कन्फ्यूज़ हो जाओ कि ये मैंने क्या लिख दिया, तो फिर तो आपका टोटल वेस्ट ऑफ टाइम हो जाएगा. बिकॉज फेस टू में आपसे भले ही ये ना पूछा जाए, पर RBI ने क्या इनिशिएटिव्स लिए हैं, क्या रिसेंट लिमिट्स हैं, और गवर्नमेंट स्कीम्स में से तो आपसे ज़रूरी पूछा जाएगा. एंड दिस इज गाइज नॉट जस्ट फॉर स्पॉटलाइट, यू कैन यूज़ दिस मेथड ऑफ क्रिएटिंग द फैक्ट शीट्स फॉर योर PIB 247, फॉर योर RBI 247 ऑल्सो. सो जस्ट अंडरस्टैंड द वे एंड मेक फैक्ट शीट्स इन अकॉर्डेंस विद द विद योर चॉइसिस, हाउ योर मेमोरी वर्क्स. एंड सेकेंडली कम से कम इतना तो उसको अच्छा बनाना कि आप अगर खुद 2 महीने बाद उसको पढ़ने बैठो तो आपको समझ में आए कि न्यूज़ क्या थी. ओके, सो वी हैव डन विद द न्यूज़ ऑफ IIT रुड़की. नेक्स्ट इज IIT खड़गपुर विच इन कोलैबोरेशन विद रिलायंस ऑर्गेनाइज्ड द ग्लोबल एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप समिट. एंड दिस इज गाइस क्लियरली एविडेंट फ्रॉम द इक्वेशन दैट आई हैव पुट हियर. IIT KGP plus Reliance equals to Global Entrepreneurship Summit 2022. थीम दाइस इज इनोवेशन फॉर इंक्लूजन. थीम आपको हर बार पूरा ही लिखना चाहिए मेरे अकॉर्डिंग, क्योंकि अदरवाइज अगर आप थीम को शॉर्ट फॉर्म करके लिखोगे इनोवेशन इंक्लूजन, बस इतना ही, फॉर को हटा दिया, तो इट वुड बी कन्फ्यूजिंग फॉर यू, क्योंकि थीम्स में बहुत क्लोजली रिलेटेड ऑप्शन आपसे दिए जाते हैं, आपको दिए जाते हैं इसलिए. ठीक है, देन IIT खड़गपुर वॉज अगेन इन द न्यूज़ फॉर परम शक्ति सुपर कंप्यूटर. ओके, सो परम शक्ति सुपर कंप्यूटर इज लोकेटेड एट विच इंस्टीट्यूशन, देन द आंसर इज IIT खड़गपुर. एंड देर इज नथिंग एल्स दैट शुड बी रिटन हियर अलॉन्ग विद दीज टू वर्ड्स, बिकॉज दीज टू वर्ड्स आर समराइजिंग द एंटायर न्यूज इन इट सेल्फ. देन वी हैव IIT दिल्ली विच वॉज इन द न्यूज बिकॉज इट्स इनक्यूबेटेड सेबियोसिस. ऑब्वियसली इफ एन इंस्टीट्यूशन हैज इनक्यूबेटेड anything, then it could nothing else be than your startup. So it is the startup. Febiosis is a startup which has been incubated by the IIT Delhi. And why was it in the news? Because it created Fabium Textile. Okay, so apart from this, there could not be any other fact that the examiner would ask you from this news only. For example, it is the this textile is a bacteria free textile. So how much percentage of bacteria is it able to counter? Would that be a question in your examination? No, RBI has not gone into too much of its depth now. So fortunately, this much would suffice your preparation. Next is that AI and Robotics Technology Park has established. So guys, this is the sign that I created myself for denoting that this park has established this lab. This Fabiosis has created this Fabium textile. So this is the sign that I have created for myself to denote the creation. Okay, you can choose whatever signs is suitable for you. And if it is hard for you to memorize the signs, then do not create any signs. It is not a hard and fast rule that you have to create signs. You can just use minimum words. That is the core here. Okay. मिनिमम वर्ड्स यूज करोगे तो भी चल जाएगा, ऐसे साइन क्रिएट करना इज नॉट इम्पॉर्टेंट. ओके, हालांकि अगर ऐसे साइंस क्रिएट करते हो तो इट हेल्प्स योर विजुअल मेमोरी इन रिटेनिंग द फैक्ट्स फॉर अ लॉन्गर पीरियड ऑफ टाइम. ओके, सो हियर गाइज दिस इनोवेशन लैब हैज सपोर्टर्स. सो IIT कानपुर, IIT जोधपुर, यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ Aalto, Finland, ICMR and AIIMS. These are the organizations that are supporting this lab. And guys, this is the minimum. This is the minimum that you could have put out from the news. Ab itna to aapko yaad karna hi padega if you want to go through the RBI. Theek hai, phase 1 nikalna hai to itna yaad to karna padega. Let's finish the IIT section and then okay, so we have finished the IIT section. I hope that you have understood in which manner you have to create your short notes from the one-liner news or from the short news, because these IIT wali news are very short news. Okay, you have just the news in itself and one or two sentences of additional information. But here, now we are going to talk about the government theme. So I will tell you how can you create short notes out of the big lot of information. Okay, so there is a big lot of information in the government schemes. Now let's discuss that, how will you create. So first news is about Ramalinga Swami re-entry fellowship. Okay, I hope all of you must have covered this scheme in your spotlight of March. And if you haven't done that, then I don't think you can understand anything from this one sentence only. Okay, चलिए जिन्होंने नहीं पढ़ा है उनके लिए मैं बता देती हूँ that it is the scheme launched by the Department of Biotechnology in the year FY 2026-27 for reducing the brain drain. So that is the purpose. To bring back the Indian nationals who are there in other countries in India again. Okay, so this is the idea of Ramalingam Re-entry Fellowship. Recently, this was in the news because of its efforts. The next scheme that we have is MG Narega. Okay, so what was the news related to MG Narega? The news is that 80% of the districts, the states which have launched the MG Narega scheme, 80% of the districts of those states must have ombudsperson if the states want to avail the benefits or the funding under MG Narega. So that was the news. If you haven't read the spotlight even once, you first of all, you would not be in the place to create this kind of a short note, and secondly, you won't understand anything if you have created the short note by taking out the bold words itself only. Okay, so I hope that now you have got the right idea. How can you create yourself the notes? The next news, or we can say the scheme that was there in the news in the month of March, was the Ayushman Bharat Digital Mission. So its budget was approved for the 5 years, that is rupees 1600 crores for 5 years. And NHA, National Health Authority, implements this scheme, okay? Now guys, from this much information only, you should have a chain of events in your mind directly. Like, when was this this Ayushman Bharat Digital Mission launched? Which committee recommended this mission? What are the components of this mission? And who is the head of NHA? So these are some of the questions that you should ask yourself when you read this one line sentence. Okay, so these are the ancillary questions or the facts that should be there in your mind once you are reading any kind of fact. Okay, जब तक ये क्वेश्चनिंग करनी नहीं आएगी आपको, जब तक ये क्रिएटिव क्वेश्चनिंग का माइंडसेट डेवलप नहीं होगा, यू वोंट बी एबल टू गैदर अ लॉट ऑफ इन्फॉर्मेशन. दस यू मे फेल इन द एग्जामिनेशन. आई एम नॉट सेइंग दैट यू विल फेल, आई एम जस्ट सेइंग दैट दिस इज द माइंडसेट, दिस इज द वे दैट यू शुड अडॉप्ट टू हैव मोर इन्फॉर्मेशन एंड रिटेन दैट इन्फॉर्मेशन फॉर अ लॉन्गर पीरियड ऑफ टाइम. ओके, सो डेवलप क्वेश्चनिंग माइंडसेट इन योर सेल्फ. Next scheme that was there in the month of March is relief and rehabilitation of migrants and repatriates. Now, from this entire scheme, what are the facts that I have picked up here? First is the tenure. So it got extension clearly. From this tenure itself, it is evident for all the students that the scheme must have got extension. Okay, so clearly for 5 years. Budget 1452 crores, okay? And purpose is to help basically the refugees or the people who have come in India from other nations. So this scheme has helped Bangladeshi refugees in West Bengal. So this is one of the examples where this scheme has proved its mettle. Okay, that it helped Bangladeshi refugees who are there in the West Bengal to a great extent. So this is one example that was cited in the news itself, right? So this is from the news. Next scheme is modernization plan 4 for Central Armed Police Forces. Clearly from this, you can yourself judge that it is the fourth phase of this scheme. And whenever you have covered it in spotlight in detail, then you would have covered other phases as well. Now, when you are reading your short note, when you are reading your fact cheat sheet, then you should ask yourself, why was this in the news particularly? Oh, right, it got an extension. Okay, so here fourth phase is written. So was there earlier phase that was there in the news? Yes, phase 3 was there. So, but is there any fact that you need to remember from exam point of view from the phase 3? No, not much. Anything significant is not there. Then what are the things that I need to remember that can be asked in the examination? So this budget can be asked. Rupees 1523 crores. Ministry is Home Affairs Ministry, because this, although such armed forces come under the ambit of Ministry of Home Affairs, but still there are certain schemes that may appear to belong to a certain ministry, but sometimes it happens that another kind of ministry is implementing that scheme. For example, you are Member of Parliament, Legislative Assembly, Local Area Development Scheme. Member of Parliament, Local Area Development Scheme. So which ministry is implementing it? It is Ministry of Statistics and Program Implementation, which is a really, really far, far away connection. Can you draw any connection between Ministry of Statistics and the MP-led scheme? Not at all, right? So in this cases, you can write ministry's name also. So the next scheme that was there in the news is this, Building AI Readiness Among Young Innovators Program. So young is here, so how much young? Obviously, we must be talking about younger lot. So these younger children belong to classes 6 to 10. Then what is the next fact? DST plus Intel India. Obviously, these two organizations are launching it. So in this manner, if you have a look of the fact sheet again and again, you would be easily able to memorize the content because this would store in your visual memory. Okay. Then we have the eligibility criteria. I wrote eligibility criteria here so that you can understand it better. But if you are preparing the fact sheet for yourself, then you don't have to write it in this manner. I just wrote it to make it a bit easier for all of you to understand, for those who have read Spotlight and for those who haven't read it yet. Okay. So under this eligibility criteria, students enroll under the DST's Inspire Awards Manak scheme. So in order to become eligible for this program, students need to become a beneficiary of this program again. Now, what is this program? First of all, what is this Manak? So I have written the full form of Manak as well. Million Minds Augmenting National Aspirations and Knowledge Scheme. So this is the full form of Manak, and Manak basically has been launched by Department of Science and Technology plus National Innovation Foundation India. So these two have launched it, and purpose is to recognize 1 million innovative ideas. If you have read this scheme, then you would easily draw the connections. Now guys, the next scheme that was there in the news was MSME Innovation Scheme, and you can use these kinds of smart art, or you can draw yourself, because drawing again helps our visual memory in retaining the facts for a longer period of time. So I created it from the word itself. If you are writing it from your hand, then it would be a lot easier for you to create such kind of structures. So MSME Innovation Scheme. So here, there are two parts of the scheme. First is that help would be given to the host institutes, and how much host institute will get rupees 15 lakh. And here I have written MSMEs are going to get the help. Now here, what is the difficult part? The difficult part is the amount that you need to remember. Therefore, amounts are specific. Okay, so this much amount would be given for plant and machinery purchase. Now here you would notice one thing. There is not even a single word that is of a useless, that is here for a useless purpose, or unnecessary words are not here. Okay, and similarly, you have to also follow this approach. Eliminate every unnecessary word that is there. You would say that for is unnecessary. No guys, for me it is not unnecessary because I have to teach you all. But if you are preparing the short note for yourself, then you can write it in this manner, because again, do keep this thing in your mind whenever you are reading this fact cheat sheet again, when your phase 2 comes, because here we are going through the government schemes and they are definitely important for your phase 2 also. So whenever you are going through the fact sheet again after 1 or 2 months, then you should be in a position to retain and remember all the facts whenever you just read this sheet. Okay, once you have a glance at this sheet, you should be able to recollect all the facts that were there. And if you prepare it in such a manner that you are not able to do so, then it won't be a good thing for you all. Okay. Chaliye, so MSMEs would get 1 crore under this scheme for purchase of plant and machinery. Now, guys, there is one thing I haven't written the ministry here, because the ministry is very obvious ministry of MSME. Until or unless there is an anomaly between the name of the ministry and the scheme, you don't have to write the name of the ministry. Okay, because MSME ka kaun karega? Ministry of MSME, obviously, right? That is why I skipped that information. But whenever I remind or try to revise the scheme, I will definitely recall it in my mind that yes, Ministry of MSME has launched this scheme, MSME Innovative Scheme, that is to boost the innovative strength of the MSMEs. Okay, it is going to be in two parts. One part would be catering to the host institutions that would provide incubation support and other kind of support to the MSMEs, and other part would directly cater to the MSMEs. Host will get rupees 15 lakh as the financial aid from the government, and the MSMEs would get 1 crore for purchasing the plant and machinery from the government. But MSMEs are going to get additional help from SIDBI, and that help from the would be from the SIDBI's cluster fund, special fund. And that is also rupees 1 crore. So total 2 crore rupees will be given to the MSMEs. Now the SIDBI's amount will be given for a specific purpose. Design, patent and idea commercialization would be the purpose for which SIDBI would give price to financial aid to the MSMEs. So these are the facts that I would try myself to remember whenever I look at the fact sheet, cheat sheet. Now guys, there are three sub-components of this MSME innovation scheme, and these three sub-components you can see yourself. Under the innovation support, MSME idea hackathon will be organized by the Ministry of MSME. Under the design support, all these institutions are going to provide support to the MSME so that they can develop more and more good kind of innovative kind of solutions. Okay, products mein innovation aaye, and innovation in the work process also is going to be there, a part of this MSME innovation scheme. Now, again, this much of information we can recall, because this is conceptual part, and conceptual part is way more easier than the factual part. Therefore, I have written just the fact here. So in the design components, the micro enterprises, not only these institutions are going to provide the technical kind of support to the MSMEs, but funding support, financial support will also be given. So micro enterprises would get 75% of the total cost of the project as funding support, and small and medium enterprises would get 60% of the total cost of the project, which is subject to upper ceiling of rupees 40 lakhs. So this is again a fact that I have just written here. Students get 75%, students who are helping the MSMEs or who have started the basically project, MSMEs, which involves students also. So 75% would be given to them, rupees 2.5 lakh worth of support will be given to these people. Intellectual property rights support. So in this support, government is going to pay for the IPR registration, and these are the limits that are written here. So once you have this pasted on your wall and you are going to go through this list again and again, then obviously you are going to retain these figures for a longer period of time. Okay, so this is how you can create this entire MSME innovation scheme into this much part. Okay, although it seems a lot bigger right now, but once you write it in your hand with your hands, then it would be bit shorter. Okay, the next scheme that was there in the month of March is strengthening of pharmaceutical industry. So let's have a look at the facts that I have put out or carved out from this news. Strengthening of pharmaceutical industry. Obviously, objective is very evident from the name itself. It is going to help the pharmaceutical industries, particularly the small industries that are there. FY26 is here. That means it certainly must have got an extension. Okay, 500 crore, it would be its outlay. Money aid to pharma clusters for creating the infrastructure or common facilities. So this is, guys, the basic purpose. It is going to provide help to the clusters, and those clusters are going to create the infrastructure. Now this much depth is required from you for your ESI also, okay? Because in your ESI you have 30 questions of objective nature. So in that you can expect a question on this information also. So interest subvention and capital subsidy on loan to pharma clusters. So aid will be provided in this manner. Now, the strengthening of pharmaceutical industry scheme has three components. Give me a second. and these three components are right in front of you. So I hope that this kind of a chart will help you once you create it with your hands in memorizing the entire component better. So here we have assistance to pharmaceutical industry for common facilities. This is first component, and from the name itself it is very evident what kind of assistance would be given here. Now the budget is 178 crore, so you can write down the name of the components in full or in part, whichever suits you the best. But do remember that you should be able to remember the complete name of the scheme. Acronyms yaad karne se kuch nahi hoga. For example, you have written Sarathi initiative, or for example NAM. But if you don't remember the full form of NAM, then it is of no use, because full forms become a question in your examination. You should be aware of the full forms. Okay, this is of primary importance, because full form se hi aapko objective bhi yaad ho jata hai. Theek hai? So this is first component. Now you can see the second component, which is pharmaceutical technology upgradation assistance scheme. So under this, help MSME to meet international standard. Okay, this is the purpose of this component. Interest subvention, how will the help be provided? By the way of interest subvention. So 5% for general and 6% for SCST MSMEs or credit linked capital scheme of 10%, and budget is 300 crore for 5 years. So all the facts are written here, nothing else. So similarly, you have to also follow the same approach. Pharmaceutical medical devices promotion development scheme, budget is there. And here the next point is that do research for promoting industry. So under this, this is promoted research for boosting the pharmaceutical industry will be done. Now we have this scheme in the news in the month of March, credit guarantee scheme for subordinate debt. So here you can see what are the facts that I have carved out. First is the budget, 20,000 crores. Then I have put a semicolon, launch 2020, gives loan to promoters. Guys, this is the peculiar feature of the scheme. It gives loans to the promoters, and what kind of loan? 15% of their stake. This is again a fact, or rupees 75 lakh, whichever lower. So I have eliminated S because it would take a lot of time and effort from my mind in reading that entire sentence and then visualizing it, okay? Guarantee, 90% would be given by government, 10% would be promoter's guarantee, 10% would be on the margin of the promoter, and repayment 7 years, moratorium 10 years max. This is, guys, the entire summary of this scheme, and I hope that the conceptual part of it is there in your mind already. Then guys, PLI scheme for textile, I have chosen for a specific reason, because PLI schemes are really, really a big lot of facts. Here, a lot of facts are there that you have to memorize. Therefore, I have deliberately picked up one PLI scheme so that I can show you how you can summarize the government schemes as well. Okay, so PLI scheme was not there in March spotlight. I just picked up, and you can see how you can create the fact cheat sheet of these government schemes as well. Okay, so here guys, this much is your PLI scheme for textile. Don't be surprised here. Everything is here. Don't feel cheated. It is fact cheat sheet session, but I'm not cheating you at all, because every fact is mentioned here. If you want, you can check it out from the PLI document that has already been provided to you all. So PLI scheme for textile. Itne chote mein dekhkar vishwas nahi hota, but mujhe pata hai ki ये इतने में कवर हो सकती है, और इसी तरीके से आपको और पीएलआई स्कीम्स और दूसरी गवर्नमेंट स्कीम्स भी शॉर्ट करनी है, ठीक है, खुद के लिए, ताकि आप उनके फैक्ट्स को, उनके कंपोनेंट्स को फॉर अ लॉन्गर पीरियड ऑफ टाइम तक के लिए याद रख सकें. एंड कंपोनेंट्स के लिए यू कैन यूज चार्ट्स, लाइक थ्री कॉम्पोनेंट्स आर देयर, आइदर यू कैन ड्रॉ दिस वे, यू कैन ड्रॉ दिस इन दिस मैनर. सो ऑल ऑफ दीज आर जस्ट वेज इन विच यू कैन क्रिएट create a smart art on your own, okay? So PLI scheme for textile, first of all the budget, the tenure, the expected, obviously PLI schemes expects a lot. So what does this scheme expect? Turnover 3 lakh crore. obviously it is for 5 years, so 3 lakh crore in the coming 5 years. Investment, 19,000 crore. So this is the abbreviation of investment. Employment, over 7.5 lakh crore. Focus, high value man-made fabric. So guys, textile comes, under textile comes every kind of fiber. So which is the particular focus here? This is also again a fact that may skip your mind. So in order to retain it better, it is easier or it would be recommended to write it down. Okay, garments and technical textile industries in tier 3 and 4 cities. Then eligibility. So here two phases would be there. Phase 1, firm invests 300 crore on profit of 600 crore, then the firm would become eligible. Second phase, invest 100 crore on 200 crore, get incentive. Okay, so this is how you can also summarize it. And total 64 items have been selected for this incentive scheme. So this is guys the PLI scheme for textiles. I hope that now you have got an idea how you can create a fact sheet for your government schemes. Let's talk a bit about the national news segment as well. Otherwise, you will all feel cheated, right? Ki aapne sirf government schemes ke baare mein bataya, sirf IITs ke baare mein bataya, baaki sections kahan gaye spotlight ke? Theek hai, to chaliye MSME, national ke baare mein baat kar lete hain. So here guys, the very first news that you would have encountered in your spotlight is this. MSME conclave for national SCST hub. So where was it organized? Sindhudurg, Maharashtra. What are the facts? These two are the facts. Just write it down. Okay, one more thing that I want to say here. Sometimes it happens that many news are here, are there in front of you, and you get confused that which news should be put in the fact cheat sheet. So here, my recommendation for you all is, only put the facts that are very hard for you to remember. For example, here, you may confuse the exact venue of this conclave. Okay, that is why I have written the conclave here. What are the objectives? Who has attended this? All of these are just the additional information. So you can clearly skip those information. Bhasha certificate selfie campaign. So guys, this is the second news that was there. Okay, Ministry of Education and my government is involved in this selfie campaign. Bhasha Sangam mobile application is there. So from the name itself, you should be able to recollect the conceptual part of this news, because the fact part is there in front of you. Conceptual part is your responsibility. Give a challenge to your mind. Otherwise, it will become dormant. Okay, so this much is here. Then 22 official languages are there, and 100 sentences would be there. So these two are again the facts. 28th DST CII India Singapore Technology Summit. So theme is here, building economies for the future. This theme can be asked. Partner, you could have skipped it, or actually I could have skipped it, because Singapore is written in the name itself. So partner is obviously Singapore. Global Innovation Alliance Centers of Singapore in Bangalore. So it is already there. It has not been established during this summit. It is already established and working in Bangalore. So this should be the information that you should recall once you are reading this news. Okay, from the fact sheet. And an MOU was signed during this meeting between the Singapore's Ministry of Trade and Industry and Department of Science and Technology for cooperation. If you are able to memorize a lot of fact, you could have skipped this fact as well, but I wrote it here because there are certain students who are not able to memorize all the facts that are there. For example, I take the example of myself. If I am in your shoes, I won't be able to memorize that which MOU was signed during which summit. Okay, so in order to better keep that thing in my mind, I would definitely write this here, just like I have done it. Okay. So guys, the fourth news is FSSAI star rating system for packaged food. Okay, so it is based on IIM Ahmedabad's report. Apart from this, there is nothing much. Everything is conceptual. So I have just put out the fact that may skip my mind. Okay, and this could become a question. So I have just written down this much only. Now guys, there are more than 150 news in your national section only of March Spotlight, and you all also understand this fact that it is not possible to cover each and every news. So I hope through the example of these four news items and other news that we just discussed, you would have get an idea how can you prepare your own fact sheet. Let's talk about the banking and economy section as well, because this is one of the most important sections. Okay, so as I told you in the beginning itself, I have categorized the spotlight into different categories. So all the news related to RBI are put under this category. So here the first news is that RBI exempted UCB. UCB is Urban Cooperative Bank, and every banking aspirant should be aware of the full form, so no need to write it here. Investment in umbrella organization, which would be an NBFC. Now with this word umbrella organization, this word should trigger a chain of events in your mind, okay? The related facts to this umbrella organization, that RBI allowed it, this is going to be a self-regulatory organization for the Urban Cooperative Bank, this is going to help the banks in creating the infrastructure, in helping them boosting their digital infrastructure, at the same time in lending also, this is going to function like RBI functions for the bank. So it is going to function in that manner for the Urban Cooperative Bank, but regulation would not be there. Okay, so these are some of the conceptual things that should be there in your mind once you are reading the fact sheet. Okay, so exempted UCB's investment in Urban Cooperative Bank from the limits imposed on holding the non-SLR securities. So this is, guys, mentioned in this circular. This particular circular of RBI provides that maximum non-SLR investment should be equal to the 10% of the bank's total deposits as of the March 31st. And obviously, we would be talking about the 31st March of the previous year, right? RBI plus intellect equals improved quantum core banking solution. What could it be? I hope that you all remember it. In the recent spotlight revision session also, I discussed this question, I think. But in March, it is there. So if I hadn't discussed it yet, I'm going to discuss it in the next session of Spotlight, definitely. So RBI and Intellect System is a core, is an IT company. So these two have collaborated for this solution for improving the digital banking. RBI plus NPI together launched UPI 123 Pay for feature phones. Four models would be there on which this UPI 123 Pay would run: SMS, missed call, app or sound based devices. That's all. UPI 123 Pay is complete. So this is how you should prepare your notes from the banking sector. And this is, guys, additional information that was attached to UPI 123, and that is NPCI's DigiSathi payment helpline. Okay, so this is another fact. Next, RBI Act 1934 to regulate National Bank for Financing Infrastructure Development, KV Kamath is in the bracket, means it's the chairman. And it is going to be the fifth AIFI, All India Financial Institution, after the Exim, NABARD, NHB, National Housing Bank, and SIB. Okay. RBI cancels license. So here this bank is written, and in March only one news was there in relation to the license cancelling. But if there are other banks also, so you can just write in pointers. RBI has cancelled the license of these banks, and in bracket their locations. Okay. So this is how you can create the fact sheet from the banking segment also. And guys, as far as the GDPs are concerned, GDPs are provided to you in a summarized manner only in your GDP forecast document, so you don't have to worry about it. Okay. And other segments ki baat ki jaye agar, for example, the memorandum of understanding. Okay. Ministry of Education signed, suppose this is the complete news, signed an MOU with IIT Kanpur for women empowerment or women financial inclusion. And women empowerment. Okay. So this is the purpose. So what are the facts that you can take out from this entire news in your fact sheet? Ministry of Education plus IIT Kanpur, women empowerment, financial inclusion. in this manner, you can just pick up the bold highlighted words that are there in your spotlight and create the fact sheet for the one-line sentences, okay? Like your MOUs are there, like your appointments. In appointments, what do you have to do? For example, ICICI Bank ka MD appoint hua hai. So, Sandeep Bakshi. Name should be written in full because otherwise you would confuse the name of the person. MD. Okay? And if you don't want to write the designation, it is also okay because obviously, we usually talk about the head honcho of the organization, okay? So, you can skip that as well. So, we have talked about the appointments, we have talked about the MOUs. What else is remaining? The defense sector. So, for example, if BrahMos, naval version has been tested with an increased range of 300 kilometers, from the Abdul Kalam Island. So that should be the manner in which you would write it in your fact sheet. Okay. So here I hope that this is now clear from the defense segment. From agriculture also, in agriculture you don't have much news, you have only 4 to 5 news that are of importance, and usme se bhi aapke zyadatar facts table mein hi diye jate hain. For example, your advance estimate for food grain production, so that is already there in the table. Okay, so you can just create the table here again if you want, or you can just have a look at the table of food grain production again and again, because that is important. Okay, now we have discussed about every other section. So in awards also, what you can do, write the name of the person and the award. That's it. Why has the person been given that award? This is not important. Unless it is the Nobel Prize. Okay, whenever it is about the Nobel, you should remember who has got the award, from which country does that person belong, for which reason has he got the award, he or she got the award. So these are some of the things which you can create in your fact sheet again. Okay, now comes the important days segment. Because this is, guys, one of the important, one of the most tricky section or the lengthy section that students find very confusing. So here, I always say this trick because this trick really works, okay? So suppose you have Civil Defense Day on March 1st. And you have Zero Discrimination Day also, okay? So I don't have much space here, but if you are writing it in your, with your pen, then obviously you would have much more space than this. So here I am writing Zero Discrimination Day, because by this much only I would be able to retain that, yes, it is Zero Discrimination Day. Then on March 3, we have World Wildlife Day. Then there is one more day on March 3, and that is your Birth Defect Day. Birth defect, bus. This much is enough, okay? For example, on March 4th, you have your National Safety Day. That is enough. National safety is enough. So in this manner, you can write down the days along with the dates and take up and just paste the calendar in front of you. Okay, so if whenever you have a look at the timetable, yes, 3rd March 2022, it was the World Wildlife Day or Birth Defects Day. Both of these days fall on the same date, okay? In my opinion, you would also be able to remember the day as well, which definitely won't be asked from you in the examination, but this is just, I'm saying this is just an easy method to remember the important days. As far as the themes are concerned, so for themes, what do you have to do? Whenever you are having a look at the calendar, you are looking at the calendar, Civil Defense Day it is, what is the theme? Try to recall. Because theme, guys, is in the alphabetic order, okay? So you can remember it in your mind, and if you are not able to remember it in your mind, so you have looked at the Civil Defense Day, check out from the spotlight, okay? Check out in the spotlight what is the theme. And once you do it 3 to 4 times, then it would be easier for you to know the theme and retain it for a longer period of time. So guys, here everything is discussed. Every section I have taken up. I have just not discussed the miscellaneous section where you have your obituaries and your authors, because on the one hand, you can write your author, and on the other side, you can write the name of the book. So this is very obvious. In sports, what you can do, suppose we have Asian Weightlifting Championship, which is there already ongoing. So Asian Weightlifting Championship is already running. So where is it, first of all, happening? Ulaanbaatar in Mongolia. This is the venue. Now, how many medals has India won? So suppose 8 medals has India won. It is still ongoing, so we don't know the exact number of medals. Definitely, it is going to increase. So 8 medals, or suppose 12 medals has India won. So out of these medals, how many golds? How many silver? How many bronze? Because when there is a long list of winners, then you don't have to remember the winners exactly. You just need to know the total number of medals that India has won. So I hope, guys, I have clarified your doubts on how you can prepare your own fact sheet. And guys, this is the standard way that I know, but this is not the watertight compartmentalization of the method that you should opt for creating the fact sheet. You are free to create the fact sheet on your own. Just keep in your mind that the word limit should be limited in the fact sheet. Plus, it should be comprehensive. It should cover all the facts that are necessary from your exam point of view. And third point that is important for making a good fact sheet is that you should be able to recollect all the facts if you are looking at the fact sheet after 2 months as well. So if all these three qualities are there in your fact sheet, then it is well and good, and you don't have to follow the way that I have told you. And if you don't have any other way to create the fact sheet, then you can follow this, obviously. Thank you so much, guys. Here I would like to end this session. I really enjoyed this session. I hope that you also have enjoyed it. Thank you so much. Prepare hard and do prepare your own fact sheet and write it with your hands also. Because if I give you the fact sheet, you won't be able to remember it. It is going to be another spotlight for you, okay? Because it would again become a big chunk of papers, right? So prepare it for your own self. Thank you so much, guys, for watching the video.